the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the hall.
I would like to begin by congratulating each one of you who are graduating from St. Simon Stock School. The way this year ended certainly has been extraordinary. I know that each one of you has labored hard to reach this moment in your lives. We now look to commemorate this occasion in a very fitting way. St. Simon Stock School has been in existence for 94 years. And I suspect that this is the first year that there was no graduation ceremony where the graduates were able to get together and celebrate. And we all feel bad about this. But our hope is that this video will help you to say goodbye and at the same time look forward to a bright future. Graduation is a time of transition. It is an ending and a beginning. You will all go your separate ways to pursue your different goals. New schools will open their doors to you. Newer friends await you on the horizon. All transitions are difficult because they involve ambivalent feelings. Each of you is probably happy and sad at the same time. You are happy to be leaving St. Simon Stock. No more plaid school uniforms. Yet you are also sad. You will be leaving behind some friends and teachers. I invite you to think about the people in your class. Many will be going different ways, and you may not see them again. And as you go through this graduation ceremony, these feelings will hit you. Some will be sad, some will laugh, and some will hold it all in. But for all, transition is not easy. I suspect each of you may be asking yourselves two very basic questions. First, what am I going to do? What are you going to do with your life? What school are you going to go to? And what friends are you going to make? Are important questions. And you can answer these questions knowing that you have received a good educational foundation here at St. Simon Stock. You have gone to one of the best schools in the Bronx, and you have been given a good education. And because of your achievement and the foundation you have received, you have been accepted into some of the best schools in the area. A good foundation has been given to you so that you could be in a position to make a reality out of your dreams. Whatever you do, don't stop growing in the area of your intellect. Be good thinkers. If you do this, your dreams can come true. We live in a neighborhood where it is difficult to dream, difficult to be good thinkers. People will be offering you an easy way out. As you well know, the temptations in our neighborhood are great. You know as well as I do that there are many youth who are not going to reach their potential because they have failed to use their minds. They have stopped growing in the area of their intellect. Developing your intellect, continuing your education, is your ticket to success. But a diploma is not the only thing that is necessary for success. Developing your intellect is not the only thing you have to be concerned about as you move on. And that is where the second question comes in, which I think is more important than the first one. The second question each of you should be asking yourselves is, what am I going to be? This may sound like that first question, what am I going to do? But it's very different. The reason for this is very simple. What you are as a person is so much more important than what you do or what you know. What you are continues to manifest itself in areas far beyond your job or occupation, by which we so often define people. Asking yourselves the question, what am I going to be, gets to the heart of who you are. It challenges you to be known as a good person, a kind and thoughtful person, generous with your time and energy in various projects that take you out of yourself and into the world. Be someone people can trust. Above all, be a person of faith. You have been given a good grounding in your faith and the teachings of the church, but you now have to live these in the world. Your values, your ideals, your moral code are going to be challenged every day. It will not be easy for you to be faithful to God, to prayer, and to the church. It is not going to be easy to stand up for what you believe, and that is my challenge to you. That is what will make you successful. In the end, this will be the yardstick to measure whether the Catholic education so many have labored to give you will have any difference, make any difference in your lives. Your principal, Miss Braswell, should be thanked. It is because of her hard work and dedication that the school continues to survive. Her care and concern for the children of our school is unlimited. She is here because she wants to be here. I appreciate all she has done for the school. You have had all excellent teachers, and they also should be thanked. As I said, what makes a person is not the degrees that they hold, but their character. And your teachers are characters with character. They are not here for the money. They are here because they enjoy the teaching profession and being here at St. Simon Stock School. They have shared their faith, their knowledge with you so that you can reach your potential that we talked about. And finally, your parents need to be thanked. I know many of you have had to sacrifice to send your children to St. Simon Stock. Meeting the financial responsibilities of the tuition payments is not easy. Yet your sons and daughters who are graduating today are the fruits of your sacrifice, and I hope you are satisfied. Before ending, I would like to give a shout out to Dalton Grant, who will be retiring at the end of this year. I don't know if there are any other teachers retiring or leaving. If memory serves me correctly, Dalton arrived here at St. Simon Stock back right around the same time I did, 1986 or 87. We were both much younger, of course, back then. This means that she has taught here in the school for about 33 years. On behalf of the school and the Archdiocese of New York, I would like to thank her for her service. I pray that she may have many years of happy and healthy retirement. So graduates, we congratulate you and know that we will miss you. Always feel welcome to come by and visit. You are part of the St. Simon Stock family. May God bless you and may all your dreams come true. And let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we ask you to send down your blessing upon our graduates as they and their families celebrate this great milestone. May they find comfort and support as they journey through life. May they find strength in the excellence of their academic and spiritual preparation. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and success. Enable them to stay true to their dreams for your greater glory, to discern what is right, good, and just, and to use their gifts wisely in the service to others. Empower them to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love, guided by your light, so that they may use their talents to go forth and set the world on fire. And may Almighty God bless each and every one of you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I am honored to be salutatorian of class of 2020. I couldn't have done it without your help. Even though not all of us get along, we will always be a class. You guys have been there for me whenever I needed it. I just want to say that I'm thankful for you and miss you all. I am thankful also for my parents sending me to this lovely school, getting to know the wonderful teachers who taught me. I learned something new each day that I came to school, and I really do appreciate the hard work that you've done for us, teachers. We're all going our separate paths, eighth grade, so let's enjoy the time that we have left with one another. All the grudges that we have against each other stay in the past. We're beginning a new chapter in our life. I genuinely wish nothing but the best for you guys. This is a farewell for now, but I know we will see each other in the future.
Hello, everybody. It's Father Nicholas. I wish I could sort of give these words to you in person, but because of the circumstances, obviously, that's not possible. So as I was preparing today to make this video for you all and on your graduation, this passage right over here came to mind. I do not cease to give thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. That idea, that necessity of remembering is of the utmost importance. You all have been through many things, no matter how long you've been here at St. Simon Stock St. Joseph, whether for a short time or a grand time. And in those different experiences, lies moments with the sacred, moments with God, moments that are meant to fortify, strengthen, shape, nourish, and animate one's life. And the necessity then for us is to remember those times, to allow them to come to the forefront of our minds. For as we continue to journey into tomorrow, not knowing what it will hold, we know who it was that has given us the necessary strength and the necessary love to be with each other in those past days and in our current moments now. So by remembering the good times, the blessed times, the holy times, even if they're sort of in a mantle of sadness, we are able to go forward strengthened with the gift of hope into the tomorrows in which our Lord has desired for us to enter into. Now, part of that remembering calls us to pray, to slow down, and to spend time talking with God, who by His light brings these things to the forefront of our mind. That's why I put this passage right there. I do not cease to give thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. Each of us have been a gift for each other. Each of us, in all the different things that could have happened in the universe, we have all had these experiences together. We have all been put into each other's lives, and that itself shows the hand of God at work. So by remembering these things, we're able to give prayers of thanksgiving for God, for the gift of each other in our lives. Now, what will tomorrow hold? I don't know. Who will you all end up being? I don't know. But I know in the moment here and now that we are called to celebrate. Not just because it's the time of graduation, but because of what you have all been doing and what you have all done here at St. Simon Stock School. And when we celebrate today, we are remembering all those different times so we can bring them to the forefront. We can rejoice in them and we can celebrate together, even if it's only through these technological means. For this, even though how sad the time may be, there still are elements of rejoicing possible for us, moments of joy, moments that when we think about bring a smile to our face, not because it's somehow we're called to force it to our face, but it comes naturally because we have been given the fruit of joy through our experiences here together. Of course, that fruit being one of the aspects of the fruit of the Holy Spirit, something that is nourishing and strengthening to the soul. So I say it again to you all. You have to remember, I can't make you do this. Your teachers can't make you do this. You have to willingly want to stop, slow down, and remember. Remember the good times. Remember the blessings. Remember the moments of joy. No matter what sort of things have happened, in those moments, God has made Himself present to each of you, as He had to each of us, and as He has to our community. So I say it once, I said it twice, I'll say it a third time. I do not cease to give thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers, Ephesians 1:16. He wrote this letter even though he was far away from those people in Ephesus. Even though we're far away from each other, we can still have some presence with each other by remembering each other and praying for each other, offering each other up to the Lord our God, asking for His blessing to be upon all of us. So even though we may feel like we're in the wilderness, out in the woods, we're still with each other. And a part of that being with each other, even if it's in different means now, is remembering. So know that I'll be praying for you. And may God continue to bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
To the graduating class of 2020 here at St. Simon Stock School, congratulations, you did it. Given this pandemic that we are living in, we are faced with the reality of uncertainty. We are faced with many questions left unanswered. But we shall not fear. We shall have hope, because our Christian faith tells us, as our Catholic faith tells us, each week during this Easter season, we are given a reassurance that Jesus Christ triumphed over death and sin. So I would like to offer to you three words of wisdom, advice, suggestions on your next step of your educational career. The first one, to love God above all, to love God above others, and to love God as you love yourself. Number two is to give to others out of love, that act of charity towards one another for the love of God. And number three, to stay close to our Blessed Mother. Our Blessed Mother was there with Jesus, and she will also be with us during our joys, our sorrows, our pains, and our trials. So behind me, we have this statue of St. Simon Stock receiving the scapular from Our Lady. You know, we Carmelites wear the scapular. And as Our Lady entrusted St. Simon Stock with the scapular, I entrust each and every one of you to Our Lady of Mount Carmel during this pandemic and during the next couple of years in your life, that she too may also protect you and that she may walk with you in your new, in the new chapter of your lives. So once again, to the graduating class of 2020 at St. Simon Stock, I'm sorry we cannot be there in person. I'm sorry that we cannot celebrate this day together as a class, as a community, as a family. But know that this is your day to shine. This is your day to celebrate your accomplishments. And we and don't forget to thank God and your parents for all that they have done to get you through to these last couple of these years. And don't forget to thank them too as they help you the next couple of years. So once again, congratulations. God bless you. And may Our Lady of Mount Carmel, St. Simon Stock, and St. Joseph intercede for you.
To the graduating class of 2020. 5 years ago, you were my first fourth grade class at St. Simon Stock. My first couple of months with 34 students sure tested my teaching abilities. During the school year, we learned about each other and everyone's individual personalities. By the end of the year, it became hard to say goodbye and move on to the next grade. Now you are eighth graders, 5 years later, and it has been an amazing year watching each and every one of you grow into young men and women. This year has gone by quickly, and I cannot believe the end is already here. I am so excited for your futures, and I want nothing but the very best in the years to come. I know that each and every one of you will succeed in anything you put your minds to do. Remember to always work hard and never give up. The hard work isn't over when you graduate. It's just a break as you enter your next adventure in life. I know you will continue to succeed and whatever you do, because you are all great writers and poets. I am proud of all of you. And now once again, 5 years later, it is hard to say goodbye. Good luck and God bless.
Dear eighth graders, just wanted to say that despite what we are going through, I'm extremely proud of all the work that you have done this year. I know this isn't how we typically celebrate such big accomplishments. But we at St. Simon Stock want to acknowledge your hard work, dedication, and achievements. Start each day believing in your dreams. Know without a doubt that you were made for great things. Remember this day, the sense of pride and accomplishments that you take from it. Use that to move towards the next academic years to come. May you always dare to do great things in life. Once again, congratulations and continue to make us proud at St. Simon Stock. Congrats!
Having successfully completed the prescribed course of study, which has the approval of the Superintendent of Schools and conforms to the guidelines of the New York Education Department and reflects Catholic doctrine and practice, these diplomas are awarded to the following students. Aaliyah Fernandez. Amelia Suku. Ashanti Prudencio. Avery Cox. Christiane Bamazon. Destiny Quijano. Idrissa Treda. Elijah Colazzo, Fiona Ansa Cancam, Haley Maya, Haja Jallo, Hardy Vanderpool, Jaden Salguera, Giancarlo Lucas, Jeremiah Melendez, Jeremy Rosario, Jonathan Colomb, Kevin Jaca, Maria Munoz, Melanie Medina, Michaela Cruz, Naima Heskey, Noah Heskey, Rosalind Camara, Rihanna Watson, Zara Cacho, Zenaida Marin,
thank God to be here to put that ring in my daughter Sara, and I thank God for her. God bless you, my love, and I love you.
Hi, your mother. I would like to congratulate. It's been a long way.
Congratulations, Idrissa.
Thank you.
This is your day. It's just the beginning of a journey towards your success. Success is not the end, it's through the journey to achieve your goals. Know that you are loved, do your best, share with others' dreams, be forgiving, be patient, grateful, do what is right by you.
First of all, I want to say thank you to the Lord for giving me such a understandable son, such a handsome boy. And all I can say is to thank God for his life and for God to be, keep leading him for his good thing he be doing. I want him to continue growing the way he's growing. And my son is the most, I don't know, he's the greatest gift life can give me. Thank you, Lord, for his life. And God should keep him in his way, going through his high school and all the way to his college.
On behalf of Amelia's dad and I, we are proud to be her parents. We wish her all the best in the future, and we want her to keep up the good work. We are love you and proud of you.
As a mother of Rihanna, words have no bounds to express the great feelings of joy to see my child pass this milestone. I am beyond proud to be granted the opportunity to witness the proud moment. Thanks you to all the teachers for doing an amazing job. Rihanna, I want you to do good in life and be great. Love you, Rihanna.
Hello, and today I will be doing a speech in reference to my beautiful daughter, Zenaida Marin. I have to say the journey was a blessing. From the third grade to the eighth grade, I have enjoyed my journey with my beautiful child. and the hard work that she has accomplished to where she's at today. So I have to tell my beautiful daughter, keep on going and believe in yourself. Anything you put your mind to, you can achieve it in life. So congratulations, Sonida. Mama loves you. Mwah.
Kaylee, you did great things at St. Simon's Top School. We are so proud of you, and we know you're gonna do great things at high school also. We love you so, so much. Thank you.
Hey, Jaden, it's Mama. Just wanted to say that I am so proud of you. I'm so proud of all of your accomplishments. I'm not surprised though. You've always known who you wanted to be and who you are. I wish you the very, very best, and I promise to be there for you along the way if you ever need a handhold. But I trust that this is gonna go exactly the way you want it to go. We love you, we're proud of you, and we're excited to see what the future brings for you.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Estamos aquí, la familia reunida, con motivo de la graduación de mi hija María Muñoz. Queremos felicitarla. Sabemos que este es solo un paso en su larga carrera. Queremos decirle que estamos con ella y la vamos a apoyar siempre, que la queremos mucho. Estamos muy orgullosos de ti y sabemos que vas a seguir adelante con nuestro apoyo. A pesar de que estamos pasando tiempos difíciles, sabemos que tú eres una guerrera y te sabrás manejar bien en el futuro para seguir y cumplas todas tus metas.
Felicidades. I want to take this moment to congratulate everyone on 8th grade, especially my daughter Melanie, for her hard work throughout this year, and especially this moment that we all going through. Also, I would like to thank the teachers for their effort. Now that we are going to a tough situation, I would like to thank everybody and also congratulate my daughter one more time. She deserved the best, and she's been working very hard to do her best on 8th grade. I'm looking forward for a better future for her and to see her grow more and more every day.
Hi, my baby girl. I'm so proud of everything you have accomplished this year. Been very hard, but you have shown that you have everything that you need to have to be a real woman.
Just know that I will be with you every step of the way, supporting you. I love you. I'm very proud of you, Mom.
Mi amor, siempre quiero que recuerde los valores que te he inculcado, la humildad, amistad y perseverancia, para que siempre te sientas seguro de ti mismo. Esto es solo el comienzo de empezar a cosechar nuevos éxitos. Recuerda que yo estoy aquí, al igual que tu papá, para siempre seguirte apoyando en todo lo que tú necesites. Que Dios siempre te bendiga grandemente. Y recuerda, humildad ante todo. Es un don que Dios nos regala y que nunca debemos de olvidar. Te quiero mucho.
A moment no one saw coming. 2020, a year we all had big plans for. And so did I for you. You know them. I don't want to get into details. But I wanted to go big for you before you embark into high school. After coming from so many changes in 2019 and difficult moments, I want you to know that I'm very proud of you, how you have handled things. And I don't expect perfection. I expect exactly what you do. Get up and continue the journey. My little Emmanuel, that's his middle name. It means God with us. Indeed, you honor your name. I didn't want to cry either, but. And make us all proud. Thank you for being the kind human being you are. And always remember, you are not a grade for me. You are the most humble, caring, and affectionate young boy one can meet. Keep up the good work, always. what got in your heart and the center of your life. Welcome to high school and make the next 4 years of your life the greatest and most responsible of your journey, because they will be decisive for the rest of your life. Good luck to you and all your classmates from 2020. Love you guys. Love you, Emmanuel. You are my heart.
Giancarlo, muchas felicidades por tu graduación. Te deseo mucho éxito y deseo que puedas lograr todos tus sueños. Te amo, hijo.
Felicidades, hijo, por este año de tu graduación. Échale muchas ganas. Sigue adelante. Te quiero mucho.
Fiona, congratulations. The family is very proud of you. We thank God for how far he has brought you. It's my prayer that the good God should continue to bless you, guide you, give you more knowledge and understanding. I can't believe how fast you have grown to become a young adult. I know that this is not going to end here. The sky will be your limit. Once again, congratulations.
Congratulations, Naima. You are graduating. Yay! Congratulations, Noah.
Thank you.
Oh, we're so glad that you finally made it. All of your hard work and dedication has paid off.
Felicidades, soy mija, por tu graduación. Esperamos que sigas adelante y avante siempre y que no te detengas ante ningún obstáculo, que sigas triunfando y avanzando y que logres todos tus propósitos y que seas una profesionista en la vida.
Te queremos mucho, estamos muy orgullosos de ti por lograr todas tus metas. Sigue siempre adelante. En este camino no es fácil, pero no es imposible. Siempre contarás con nosotros en las buenas y en las malas. Estamos muy orgullosos de ti. Te queremos mucho. Muchas felicidades, mija.
Cuídate y felicidades.
Baby, congratulations on your graduation. We're very proud of you.
So what do I have to say about my son, Jeremiah Melendez? I'm more proud of him than anything else, because he's never stopped doing what he needs to do. He's always been a good boy, never had really any problems with him, and he always tries hard to do his best at anything that he does, and he always excels on everything.
Hey kid, congratulations on your graduation. You accomplished a lot this year, and you overcame a lot to get to this point. I am incredibly proud of you. I can't wait to see what else you got coming, kid.
Congratulations to my grandson, Elijah Colasso, on his graduation day. Elijah, keep on. I love you. God bless you.
This message is for Elijah Colasso from your mom. Elijah, just want to let you know I love you so much from the bottom of my heart. I am so proud of you. For the past couple of weeks, I've been watching you work hard and put in all the effort into your work. Congratulations on graduating 8th grade. I'm excited for you to start your new journey into high school. Keep working hard and you will accomplish your goals. May God bless you and may He protect you during this journey. I love you, and to all class of 2020, congratulations.
Buenas tardes. Yo soy Arely Sánchez, la mamá de Alia Fernández. Estoy muy orgullosa de que podamos estar en este momento. Darle las gracias a Dios, especialmente porque estamos respirando, estamos vivos, gracias a Él, a pesar de todo lo que está pasando. Gracias a mi Señor porque nos da la posibilidad de cumplir muchos sueños en la vida. Estoy muy orgullosa de Alía por el trabajo que ha hecho. Sé que ha tenido un poco de dificultades en el camino, pero con la ayuda de Dios hemos llegado hasta la meta final. Y gracias a todos sus maestros que han colaborado con su ayuda para lograr esto. Le doy las gracias a todos y que el Señor lo bendiga, lo acompañe siempre y lo cuide.
Hey, Jeremy, I want you to know that you make your father and I very proud. We are so proud to be your parents. It's been great to watch you grow into the thoughtful young man you are. You will always have our support, and I want you to always help when you can, whenever you can, and do what brings you the most joy. We love you.
Christian, I'm so happy and proud of you. Congratulations. This is just the beginning of your success. The sky is the limit. May God be with you along your successful journey. May you be the head and never the tail. May you become whatever you were created to be on this earth and leave a legacy in Jesus' name. I love you so much.
Hello to my peers, families, teachers, and staff members of St. Simon's Stock. My name is Fiona Ansakankam, and I've been attending St. Simon's Stock since third grade. I'm absolutely honored to be standing here representing the graduating class of 2020. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank all the teachers for bringing us this far. When I first came to this school, I was very nervous. Coming from a public school, I thought people would think differently of me. But I was welcomed by all the teachers and students, and now I have made a lot of friendships, some I hope that will last a lifetime. To our teachers, you have been here to hold us up and encouraged us. You supported us through our hard times, and I would like to say thank you for being our second parent. On behalf of all the eighth graders, I would like to say sorry for all the stress and issues we have ever caused. I know we haven't been the easiest class to deal with, but we hope we have made you all very proud of what we've become. You have not only taught us things we need to know in the classroom, but life outside of it. We are blessed to have people like you. We love you all and thank you. We'll try to visit when we can. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank my parents. To my mom, I would like to say thank you for all the sacrifices you made for me. I know it isn't easy since my dad isn't here. I see how hard you work and how hard you push me to always try to do my best, which has encouraged me to do so. To my dad, thank you for supporting me in what I do, and I'll always work hard to make you proud. To both of you, this is for you. This is to show you how hard I've been working for the past years. We should all thank our parents, because without their support, we wouldn't have come this far or received the best gift they've given us, a wonderful education. The best gift we can give them is working hard to achieve our goals and making them proud. To my fellow classmates, I know this isn't how we expected to be graduating, but know that our graduation is very special. As a class of 2020, we will always be a part of history as a graduating class who had a virtual graduation during one of the worst pandemics, coronavirus, also known as COVID-19. These past years have gone by so fast, but we've been through so much together and have changed and grown together. Junior high has been a crazy few years for us. All of the silent lunches and no recess throughout our years was actually worth it. It made me realize a lot of the things we did were not right, and we all knew that, but weren't willing to take responsibility for what we did. I can say we actually started taking responsibility when we had to make decisions that were going to affect us in the future. We all have gained some valuable lessons and memories that will stay with us forever. It hurts to know the people I've created bonds with for the last 6 years will all be leaving. But I know that we will all see each other again. We will be taking the first step of a new journey, and I believe St. Simon's Stock has given us the skills to succeed in life. We can become anything we want to be by just having the determination and courage. This is our next part of our journey of facing more difficult situations. So follow your passion, stay true to yourself, and never follow anyone else's path. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Congratulations, my eighth graders. You did it. You made it. Eighth grade graduation. I still remember your cute little faces on your first day of sixth grade as you came into my classroom for the first time. You were all so nervous. Don't try to deny it. You were all so nervous. You were upstairs in junior high with the mean teachers that you had heard stories about. But you survived your first day, your first week, and in the blink of an eye, here we are at the end of eighth grade, celebrating you and all of your achievements. There were times we felt like it would never get here, And then other times, the days and the weeks, they went by so quickly. When I look back now, how I wish I had more time with you. I've watched you grow over the years into amazing young men and young women, each with your own distinct personalities. You know, life's journeys take you on so many paths, and it's difficult to know where those paths will lead us. So it's important to always be the best version of who you are and always make the best of every situation you're in. Unfortunately, a few months ago, life took us on a very unexpected path. We were faced with challenges and disappointments that we never could have anticipated. Yet in all of this, I have watched you rise to the occasion and take on this challenge. You stayed motivated and focused on your goals, and I am so incredibly proud of each and every one of you for that. I know it's not easy to do that right now. This has certainly shown me how ready you are for high school, and you all are so ready for high school. So go and begin the next chapter in your life. And as you embark on your new journey, keep St. Simon Stock School and all those in it close to your heart. Be true to yourself, be true to your faith, and remember, I will always be here for you. You are going to be amazing, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds for you. I'm going to miss you more than you'll ever know. To quote the great Dr. Seuss, today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. I love you guys. Go and do great things. Thank you.
my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shields and kicks in my. Tune in everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race.
Class of 2020. I'm so proud of you for achieving your promise you made to God, your parents, and to yourself that you will work hard this school year and graduate. This year has brought on some challenges with social distancing and remote learning. However, you have worked through these challenges and accomplished a milestone in your life. You're graduating from eighth grade. Awesome. In September, you will begin a new milestone, high school. I know each of you will do an amazing job. However, there are a couple of things I would like for you to remember. As you travel through this new journey to high school, always keep God first. Look for advice from your parents and make good decisions when you're choosing your friends. This will help you stay on track with accomplishing your next milestone, graduating from high school in 2024. Please remember, the teachers, the staff, and I will miss you tremendously, and you will always, always have a home at St. Thomas Stock School. God bless. Thank you.
our life, we think about now. Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end. And suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us round? Will this memories fade when I leave this town? I keep